Hey, bad buddies. Paul Roberts, Artsy One here. I've got a few things on the desk. I've got this winch that I found the other day on the street. It's probably about a $300 winch. And somebody threw it out just because they got it tangled. I took it apart, got it untangled, and probably get rid of it. I don't know if I have a use for it. It's a very slow winch. Otherwise, I could use it to grapple up. I have a couple of these pieces laying around. This one's very flawed, and I'm going to make this into a nice battle-damaged set of legs. And then this is a display piece I've had sitting around for a long time. I don't like the fact that it's so gritty but it has a shiny texture. But I thought, no, let's try something new today. Let's try to work on this and try to get it to where it has finish itself that's above the higher texture is a different color than black and see what that does. Well, speaking of cowls, the Cowl Vault is giving away a great cowl that I helped him with for the 1,000th subscriber to his channel. So check that out. He does a lot of cowl reviews on all the different cowls in his collection, and you might find that interesting. And maybe you'll be the 1,000th subscriber and get the cowl. There's another prize too. So this cowl's already heavily plasti-dipped, and it's a heavy, thick latex piece made for just display around my cave. And I'll probably hang on to it, but I just don't like the finish that it currently has. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take some plasti-dip and a brush, and I'm gonna tint the plasti-dip with just a little bit of a different type of spray. I realize the thinners are different. We're just gonna try something different today and see if it works. So I've got like a gray, and I'm gonna just slide it along some of the texture areas and see what it starts to do and see if I like it. The great thing about this is, especially with something that's already thickly plasti-dipped, which I don't recommend doing unless you're displaying it, is I can simply plasti-dip over it if I don't like it. Look at that texture. Now, not only is it a texture, but it's actually like simulated a different color. It's accentuating the texture. It's getting to feel like maybe it's like a leather or something like that. I'm not really going white because the last thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go white in the most accentuated areas. Real easy to do. It comes right off the brush only on the upper areas. And you have to be very careful as you're doing this to randomize your brush strokes. Especially if you start to see a brush stroke, you're gonna have to cover that up later. But if you can apply it in a manner that's very delicate and graceful, then you probably don't have a problem with seeing the brush strokes, and you'll have to do less fixing up later on. Look at that texture coming out there. That looks great. I'm gonna like this so much better when I'm done with it, I think. Because sometimes the texture, unless it's lit right, like, you know, in the Hollywood films, you just don't see it on a daily basis. And I like to see what's going on in the texture. So I'll be working on that this week, a little bit on and off. And the same thing's gonna happen with this. This is gonna be considered serious battle damage stuff. The first thing I'm gonna do is plasti-dip this, because I always like to seal in my latex. I'm not gonna throw this out or battle it and try to fix it. I'm going to do battle damage. You don't have to throw things out. You can do other things. And we're gonna use the same careful technique that we've seen in other videos, but I'm gonna go a lot heavier. I want to disguise some of the problem areas. I want to detract from them by having my brushstrokes actually be very noticeable. Look at all those problems. They could be in the trash, but no. That's just where Batman, he just got too close to a blowtorch one time. He's getting out of his trap and he just got out in the nick of time. Messed up part of his suit. That's okay. And this suit's gonna take him through because it is heat resistant, of course. So I'm gonna go over the whole thing with these heavy brush strokes in this gray like this. Maybe a little bit the other way. But then kind of go with the form. You know, I always wonder, what happens if a knife or a bullet hits in one of these little pocket areas? It looks good, but I wonder. So I don't wanna go too far on this one, so certainly I'm not gonna make a whole video by itself. Because somebody that grabs this is going to want to, you know, simulate it on their other pieces or be able to use it just the way it is. If I go and start doing dustings of other colors and crazy stuff, then the legs will stand out on somebody's piece and everything else will look normal. So I don't want to do that. So I'm really not going very far with this. One of the things I like to do is in a few areas that I don't like, or even if I like it, but I think, oh, it's a little bit too bright, I just go back over with the plasti-dip and dull it down to the level I want it to be. So you've got the detail there, but it's more subtle. That's another way you can make your heavy hand work more effective in ways you want it to be. But look at this. I mean, come on. Look how messed up that would have been. There's no way you can use that unless you make it messed up. Now, here's what we're gonna do next. This is a very simple step, and I'm gonna do just a little bit of it, because if anybody's wondering if this is messed up or not. The piece has to say, yes, I am messed up. I want to be messed up. I'm aware of that. Don't criticize me. I'm gonna go around in a few of the areas that are the worst and look like, oh, you know, this was Kilmer before he had that great fireproof cape there, you know? You know, this is what happens to the actual suit if we're not careful. It's a little scorched. So look at that, just real simple treatment. And then whoever ends up with it, well, first off, they won't think it's a piece of junk, but they'll find some way to implement it. Another reason why I like to use simple techniques is when this is in the hands of a bat buddy, and especially if I can give them a little coaching, they can take it and they can work with it, or they can add other stuff to their other pieces, sort of similar to what I'm showing here. So it's user friendly, but I'm going over the worst areas on this piece with other stuff to detract from the fact that the problems are problems. Make it look like there's some kind of thing that we wanted to have happen. And just with that little bit, the inner part wasn't as bad. I'm gonna leave the inner part. And I'm gonna call that done for the video at least. I might work on it some more. But just kind of give you an idea what I'm doing on the desk this week. I gotta work some more on this. I'm getting to where, you know, I like it. Again, on this, very, very good thing to do is to take it and get it right about where you want it. Do it a little bit too much and then dull it back down just in a few areas. So it looks like it's coming through the black instead of sitting on top of the black. Like going over just a little bit until it's just the right amount of handling. That's a nice thing you can do. Go a little further than you want to go and then taper it off. That's another way to create that subtlety. I'm Paul Roberts, RT1. Talk to you later, bad buddies. Oh, speaking of picking things up out of the junk, I live in a crazy place. This is really handy. Have a rolling cart for all your various things, you know? Costume parts, capes. They get a little dusty in the shop. What I normally do is I take this possible Superman cape one day, just kind of over top of it like that. Keep the dust off while I'm not using it.